And joining me is my first guest of the night. It's Sebastian. How are you, sir?
Hello. Thanks for having me.
No worries. Thank you very much. I've got a few questions for you, Sebastian. Obviously, you're the man behind the community firmware. What was the purpose of the community developed firmware? And what are the benefits and what are the apparent, real limitations?
Well, it first started out pretty much because the stock firmware, and that was in September of last year, had some pretty big flaws. One of that being that if you canceled the print on the first layer, it would scratch your glass bed. So that was one of the things that happened. And eventually we got the source code of the Creality firmware, and well, we started pulling that up to a recent version of Marlin and started fixing some flaws. But it became pretty clear that the state of the source code at that point was not really future-proof, so to speak. So. Sure. So
was the firmware causing some problems that we've seen with the boards and things like that, or is that something totally separate from that?
That appears to be totally separate. It seems to be partly electrical issues and partly just things in the 452 board that aren't exactly right.
Yeah, sure. So, okay, again, I was watching some YouTube videos earlier, and again, thank you for coming on the show. I noted that you started working on this project even before you had the CR6 sent to you. So you were a Kickstarter backer. You were one of the guys that invested in this product. Did you get the printer that you so wished you had?
For the most part. The printer in the reviews, it looked pretty good, but it is unfortunately that after the reviews that some flaws became quite clear, like the bed leveling system is very susceptible to mechanical issues because of the amount of force that's needed to probe the points, and you can even turn that down a bit by manually changing a tiny little pop meter on the hot end daughter board, but even then it's not ideal.
Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, like I say, you've obviously done a huge amount of work, you and your collaborators as well. We're looking at the new version today, which is the version 6, is that right?
Yes, version 6, yes.
Okay, very exciting stuff. What are the key differences between the previous version and this new version?
Well, in the beta 5 version, we did a big refresh on the entire screen layouts. We really made it in our own theme, while the 4 alpha version was still Creality theme, so to speak. In this version, we actually extended everything. So we allowed much more control over various settings. We have some built-in diagnostics and calibration. For instance, you can start a mesh validation pattern, or you can calibrate your e-steps interactively. So we built some things like that.
Yeah, I noticed because I run Octoprint, Octopi, and I noticed it didn't sense the filament runout sensor correctly when you're using that. And I didn't know that. Does that work now? That works on your firmware, right?
Yes, because we completely switched to the Marlin implementation, essentially, of the filament sensor, and Creality baked is their own implementation, so then it doesn't work.
Oh, I see. I mean, I'm glad that I read your firmware information, because I had no idea, and of course I would have just blindly been printing as I normally would do, and it would have run out, and I wouldn't have been able to fathom out exactly why that happened. So I'm glad that yourself in the community have kind of looked at that. I did speak to Creality, a member of the staff at Creality, today, and obviously, they don't really want to talk too much about the CR6, especially to somebody that's potentially going to be doing an interview on YouTube. But what we did speak about was modifications to the printer, and things like modifications to the firmware would invalidate the warranty of that printer. What are your thoughts on that? How does that kind of transparent is that with the stuff that you're doing? And have Creality reached out to you to talk about any options on looking at what you're trying to develop here within a community base?
Well, Creality did reach out to me, but that was mainly on the level of that they appreciate what I'm doing, and I think it's very nice this firmware. But in terms of warranty, well, there isn't any warranty really either. So, but it's a fair point. And as you may know, for instance, Prusa has done something with the Prusa Mini that you actually need to clip away a part of the PCB to allow custom firmwares to be installed. So, but even then, I understand that Prusa says, well, if something like your stepper motors fail, then the firmware couldn't have caused that. So then it's still within warranty. So, and sure. this applies to this as well. If my motherboard blows up, the chances are really slim that it's the firmware. How are you going to prove it?
Yeah, exactly. Well, I put up a small poll earlier, and I'm sure that will fluctuate as the days and weeks go on. The idea was just to try and find out from a CR6 community point of view, how many people have kind of done the firmware upgrade and how many people are running it stock. And regarding the community, it's sort of 2-1 is the way I'm seeing it at the moment. You know, 2010 is kind of the way that's kind of looking at the moment, which I thought was really, really interesting. And, you know, I posed that question to Creality on how many people are now running this type of firmware, and they just didn't know. So I thought, just as a, you know, almost like a sleuth myself, just looking at how this was going. And obviously, from what I've read and what I've seen online, everybody says that this is a hugely positive thing. What sort of responses have you had from the 3D printing community?
Very positive responses. And that also partly keeps us going, of course, because that helps a lot. But yeah, people really like the firmware and really like that it's really building and extending on top of latest Marlin features, for instance, things like being able to override slicer detections is one of the features in the new firmware. Well, those features are really nice to have, and actually have also saved a few prints of myself. So
fantastic. Yeah. So what's your background then, Sebastian? What do you do? How do you get involved with this coding? Is that your job, or is that just something that you do as a hobby?
Well, I do it as a hobby, but I'm also a full-time web developer at a big accountancy agency. So I do have a programming as a background, but I also like to tinker with Arduinos and Raspberry Pis in my spare time. So I also know a bit or two about native code, so to speak.
Fantastic. Yeah, I mean, like I say, yeah. when it kind of boils down to firmware and things like that, you know, I run SKR boards in reasonably heavily modified CR10 S5s and Bontech and Slice Engineering stuff as well. So when it came down to kind of usability, and don't get me wrong, I'm really, really impressed with the print quality on the CR6. As stock at the moment, it's coming out really nicely. And obviously, long may that continue. And, you know, again, I dabble a little bit with code and stuff, but not at this kind of level. Surely right now this is almost like a full-time job for you, surely, because you know you've got new versions coming out all the time. It's very, very exciting. I'm sure there's people reaching out to you like myself all the time wanting to sort of get the information of what's going on and how you're feeling and what, you know, what the situation is. You know, it's that kind of 3D printing fame almost, I guess you could say. How does that work with you at the moment?
Yeah, it takes a good bit of spare time, I have still a Raspberry Pi Zero lying around. I still need to put some pin headers on, and I can't even get around to that. But
so I guess you're not getting much 3D printing done at the moment, or are you?
Well, I am. Because I also need to stress test my own firmware, and I also helped a few days ago a bit in helping some Marlin upstream from troubleshooting some serial bugs. So, but I'm certainly printing, but my own stuff comes after the firmware, and also after any 3D prints I do need to make. For instance, the replacement parts I designed, for instance.
Fantastic, fantastic. So at this point in time, where do you kind of see the improvements going with this particular type of firmware on this printer?
Well, that's a good question. The sixth release is already pretty much feature complete. So we are looking into improving the menu structure, because I often find myself lost when preheating, because the preheating settings are in the wrong menus on this printer. So those kinds of things, mainly quality of life improvements. Maybe sure. we will be looking at implementing a built-in linear advanced calibration, for instance. That kind of things we might be looking at.
Oh, fabulous. Amazing. So finally then, can this process be reversed back to stock? Or, you know, once you've upgraded, is that kind of the end of it?
No, everything is reversible to stock firmware, essentially. Because the motherboard can just be flashed back, and so can the touchscreen. People have done that successfully, especially with the 4 Alpha, which had some pretty big Alpha-style bugs.
Right, I see. But overall, the firmware, you know, rollout has been a huge success, right? You know, you guys must be very, very pleased with that. You know, and I'm, like I say, I'm all for people that push forward and push the boundaries. And I felt like, you know, when I saw this on Kickstarter, and I didn't support it on Kickstarter, I went for the BQBX, which I'm still waiting for. It's on a ship somewhere, and I really hope that I'm not going to have these kind of problems. But again, the whole selling on Kickstarter, established businesses that are out there, Big Tree Tech, Creality, those major players that are out in the marketplace, it surprised me that the process had been that lumpy. Did that surprise you at all when you got the printer? Did you think you were going to be kind of traveling down this route that you are now, where you're actually, you know, making your own firmware up? Was that in your mind at all?
No, not at all. I mean, it was technically my first 3D printer I purchased.
Wow.
So in that sense, no, I totally didn't expect that, but the process just started gradually as the source code became available. I didn't have my printer yet. Some other guys had their printers. So we started playing with everything and figuring out how it works. And well, eventually I got my printer. It unfortunately that also died within a month, but that's different story.
Yes. I mean, just touching on that slightly for a second. What's the idea about the Big Tree Tech boards going into these printers? Is it because they fit, or because there is a certain application that works well for your integration of your firmware? What's the deal with that?
Well, I think that Big Tree Tech decided to jump on this printer because the 452 boards had a lot of failures.
Yeah.
Just random failures a lot. And I think they just saw a market opportunity, essentially. So they took it and they designed the board for it. Now the board is not without its downsides too, but it is a pretty good board, and I have it in both printers now. So in that sense, it's a pretty good board. And if I want to change my stepper motor currents, for instance, I can just do that, because like I would expect from Big Tree Tech, everything is firmware controlled.
Absolutely. Is there anything any advice that you can give to anybody that's about to start this upgrade? I spoke to another user who's on the community firmware earlier on in the week, and he said, read through the GitHub page 3 times and then follow it word to word when you're copying things over. Is that kind of the general stance on that, or have you got some additional information?
No, that is essentially it. The 4 Alpha release was also a kind of learning experience, because it's also you're writing instructions and people are interpreting it in a different way. Well, that was also the learning experience, to get those instructions more specific, more detailed. And I think we're now at the point that the instructions are detailed enough, but there's also several YouTube videos on how to flash the firmware. So
yeah,
I think people can figure it out pretty good by now. Yeah,
Good. Is there much that can go wrong while doing this, or is you're not going to brick the board or anything like that? It's pretty self-explanatory, right?
Yes. What we sometimes see is that 4-5-2 boards, and only those boards, will sometimes sort of freeze while flashing the firmware, and then you need to rename the bin file and try it again, and then it works. And of course, because you need to disassemble the touchscreen, you must also take care that you don't accidentally let it short on some metal or something like that.
I see. Okay. Well, thank you very much, Sebastian. What we're going to do now, though, we're gonna flash it. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. Okay. So what we do is I'll pop this into here. The other thing I'll do is I'll just share a screen real quick. I did see that I needed to maybe call this, because normally when you flash this stuff, it's firmware.bin. Okay.
Yeah.
For like Big Tree Tech stuff. Now, what does this? One user said it needs to be firmware1.bin. Does it need to be a different file name, or will that go straight in as is?
No, it will go straight in as is. The problem is mainly with the Creality boards, is that they remember the last file name of the flashed firmware. So if the flashing doesn't go 100% right, then you need to rename it to force it to reflash. And the Big Tree Tech boards, they indeed use firmware.bin and then rename the file afterwards when the flashing has been successful.
Okay, so using a Creality board now, this file will be fine.
Yes.
The second unit that I have here, get rid of that, doesn't matter, is the screen. And
yes.
I believe it's just this dwin underscore set. Is that all I need?
Yes, you copy that folder, not the contents, but the folder itself to a correctly formatted SD card. And that's also where the trick is, because... formatting is more difficult on a Mac than on a Windows computer, and you also need to have the right size of SD card.
Lucky for me, I've also got a Windows computer here. So what I did is I took that and I edited it down FAT32, and is it 46200 or something? Whatever the file name. What does it need
the
to
right,
be?
The right sector size, 4096. Yes.
Okay. Brilliant. Okay. Well, what I'll do then, I'll eject that one. Okay, so in short then, I've got two cards here. The screen card is going to go into the screen, I hope. They've not made it easy to plug that in, have they?
No, they didn't.
Okay, so he plugs in here. I'm going to just plug him back into here. And then I'm going to take this drive here. Oh, I see what you mean about it shorting out. Okay, I'm going to get the plastic and just pop that on the back, just so I don't have any shorting out on the metal. And, of course, I'm just going to plug this in here. So it's as simple as just plugging it up, turning it on now, right?
Yes, it is.
Fingers crossed, Sebastian. Ooh. Am I looking for anything in particular here?
Well, it shouldn't say all zeros, because then it's going wrong. But if it shows some file numbers, a 1 and 2 and a 6, I believe, and some others, and the words end with an exclamation mark at the top, then it should be done.
Okay, it says SD card process. I've got a blue flashing light. How long does this take normally? A couple of minutes?
The screen takes a couple of minutes. The motherboard firmware is usually around 20 seconds. And what's also interesting, in this version, due to so many people having issues with the screen firmware, we have also added the detection to check if the screen firmware is actually flashed correctly. So as you can see here in... near your hot end, that the light is flashing.
Yep.
Well, that indicates that the firmware of the screen hasn't flashed correctly, which it hasn't, of course, because you're now working on it.
Okay, so it hasn't flashed properly.
Well, not yet, because you're now flashing it.
Oh, I see. Okay, so it's a gradual thing.
Yeah. So it should display end. with an exclamation mark at the top at some point.
It does that now, yes.
And you should see some numbers.
I do.
So it should, one of those should say 6 at the moment, I think.
It does. It's the ICL file.
Yes, exactly. So you can now turn off the printer and remove the SD card.
So it's done?
It's done.
Wow. Okay. That was super simplistic, I must say. Well done to you guys for getting that going. Okay, so switching back on?
Yeah. Sometimes the screen is a bit tricky and needs a second or third time flashing, but usually it goes right.
There we go. Oh, yeah. That's cool. That's really cool. I like that a lot. Wow. Okay. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do, Sebastian. I'll let you get back to your evening. Thank you so much for coming on and talking to me. I'll go through the menus now and obviously show the viewers, you know, what's inside of that. I hear as well you've got games on this one. Is that right?
Well, that's only if you are using Big 3 Tech Board and have the classic Marlin UI.
Damn. Yeah. Okay. No, I'm not. Well, you know, that might be the excuse that I need to perhaps upgrade then further on from that. Is there, as I say, just on the Big 3 Tech side, is there much difference between those two boards? Or are they kind of just as good as each other, but one you can't play games on?
Well, it's of course that the stepper drivers are firmware controlled. So that helps a bit with, for instance, it's said that you shouldn't run your extruder in stealth chop. So you can disable that. And then you have less chance of missing any steps there. And that port is also properly documented. So there are several expansion ports. For instance, when you want to use an UPS or a NeoPixel, I've a NeoPixel on one of the printers. So you can do things like that as well. Yeah.
Nice. Listen, Sebastian, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. And I'm excited for you because I think looking, you know, in on what you guys are up to there, I think this is very much just the start for you. You know, I wish you well, and I hope that your future is bright and, you know, full of this kind of stuff and you carry on to evolve. I think it's such a positive thing for the community. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you too.